Spike again trying to create a little bit of extra space, but GH has the movement speed. That's going to be first blood. Here. Perfect hit, perfect block, and that's first blood going the way of GH and Ame even being body blocked up by these trees. This is why you love watching Mind Control on Nature's Prophet. He makes life so hard while Chalice will go down to Miracle. Up on the top, another spike. GH in a little too deep underneath the tower. He'll die to the tier two.
Better than that.
GH is making another run on bottom lane. Ame is just being forced out. And this is exactly what they wanted, though. Fortification being burnt. Kuro will just keep like level two nether blasting out while up on top lane. Goodbye, Chalice. The jump in the back lines, X-Noble will be able to get the disruption off to binding with the cooldown. Somnus has arrived. Miracles, actually, sorry. Yeah, that TP out will not happen in time.
I feel like Liquid will want to come back to him top very soon.
They're going after Miracle.
Tower, but for now, yep.
They want him before he's level 6. FY is coming in from the side. They can easily get the Hex and the follow-up done. Even Ravage being triggered, stopping the Elder Titan, making sure nothing was going to come out from his stomp. FY, however, GH has hit so hard, plus 166 damage because all the heroes got hit by that as Mind Control beats into Chalice. But that's Chalice. That's a huge-ass Tidehunter.
Maybe very situationally. I mean, the cooldown reduction is really important.
Yeah, about to have a big fight up on top. The wraparound from Somnus as well as X-Nova. Put their Observer Wards down and now Dro Ranger into the cooldown with the Purge. Weedown won't be able to walk away from this one. He tried to TP, but that won't work either. With the Flak Cannon damage, GH and Mind Control back under the T1 tower. They are in relative safety, but Kuro's caught on the wrong side of the tracks, running away through that dire Observer Ward.
I can actually use this tower control to control more of the map than 50%, mm-hmm. LGD is doing fine.
Oh, here's your Rod of Atos going to work right on top of FY with the ET stomp. Chalice is thinking about jumping forward, and he'll think twice about it.
Also, with that DD, they Mind Control chase.
Jumping himself forward and snared up. Chalice still has that Blink Ravage available. Mind Control slow. X Nova starts creating a couple of copies, but where's the extra health? Now the Blink Ravage comes in right on top of Mind Control. Enough damage, it should be. He's actually hiding inside the Sprout, beginning his TP out. The Anchor Smash won't be enough damage. Mind Control will get away to safety. And the ET Splitter, how much have they got? Ame just wants to reset things up for a second. And he'll TP away to safety, but the Rod of Atos, it cancels it! Kuro kept the range! Ame will die, and Miracle will claim his second kill for that fight. Oh, Kuro just knew exactly where to be, right place, right spot. And they'll go in for Roshan, Ravage is down, they feel confident. No Song of the Siren either. And no buyback for the Naga, so they can't even scout. But LGD, they want to contest. In they jump, hit the Anchor Smash. Somnus, what have they really got? The cooldown will begin, but the Rod of Atos once again controlling up Somnus. The homing missile goes towards Weeha, but Chalice, defensive disruption. X-Nova trapped inside the Sprout. They've got a little bit more damage, not just a little bit, a hell of a lot more. Miracle jumps in for the double Searing Chains. A double stun will be nice, but he's still burning in the Flame Gun. Miracle, even while napping, is able to kill LGD.
Oh, that's so much more than what Liquid came for. They not only get the Roche, they get three extra kills and...
You know,
and all of them on Miracle, that's maybe not a little bit easier, that might be a lot easier.
Yeah, this is a hell of a lot easier. And the Aegis turns into, hello Ame, you've found a friend, caught inside the Sprout, the quick TP out, but is there another control? Mind Control, you can go down. Ame has just enough damage thanks to the Illusion's Riptide. But normally you use this Aegis on a Draw Ranger to go for the tier 2 towers. You just clear them out, and yeah, Tide caught out. No Ravage available. Somnus goes in for the cooldown. Ember Spirit with the Finger of Death. FY plus 40. Somnus flat cannoning out. Pakuro giving the extra life towards Weeha so he can stand his ground. But that's the BKB of Somnus, the full 10 second one burn. And now the homing missile is also chasing Weeha. They want more. FY is coming in too. He can get the follow-up chain stun with the Observer Ward and Sentry. They see a hell of a lot of information too. X-Nova, what's he got? That nice extra cast range with the four-star. It pulls Weeha a little bit further away for a three-man gust. But instead, right on top of Pugna, Chalice wants to help out as well. They still want the kill on Weeha. These homing missiles, they just never stop. Kuro will finally go down to the gyrocopter and they break the Aegis Immortal. But how much more does LGD have? Ame's waiting on the hillside. Weeha, he's just going to actually BKB and TP away under the cover of his ET splitter.
Cessna, I don't think it's possible really to brute force this, except if you bank on a big mistake from LGD.
That's interesting TP. Kuro just went right underneath the Observer and Sentry. Finger of Death comes out. Kuro's instantly exploded.
What was the plan there?
He must have thought they didn't have any kind of extra information, but that Observer Ward saw everything. Chalice is going to go down. Weeha's damage output is huge. Is he going to ravage? Weeha's still BKB'd. He didn't want to burn it. Somnus will burn his BKB and TP out.
I don't know. That was very weird.
Actually, have a small moment as Naga gets initiated on, but it's the other way around. Chalice, no Ravage to work with, but it won't matter. Weeha up way too far. Miracle thought he had his target, but X-Nova, defensive disruption. Now, finally, Miracle will be able to get it up. The Sleight of Fist wears off with a Searing Chain. He's able just to spirit himself away, but Kuro won't be so lucky. Somnus wrapped around the northern side.
A lot of damage output, and he also has no buyback. LGD don't know that, of course, but Smoke's gonna break.
Miracle with the double damage rune. Look how much damage instantly just goes into X-Nova. They have the control over on Pugna, able to find that kill. FY almost killed himself with it, but Miracle will finish the job. The buybacks coming in, SD and Pugna.
Yep.
Somnus underneath the Radiant Observer Ward's gonna be careful. We able to get the silence, but the Hex on Aegis Prophet, the Finger of Death, instantly dead from mind control. Again, one of these TPs where you don't BKB. And LGD punish hard, and the Song of the Siren may allow LGD to punish even harder. Charles, he's ready for the Ravage, combining with the cooldown. Kuro, they want to knock him down. Charles, she holds off on the Ravage, and Weeha will just BKB back out of this one. And maybe with Charles being forced off down, he could finally kill off with the Ravage. GH, he clips the back of Dro Ranger, but he has no more of a team. Miracle will come in to finish the job. Charles is down.
He lost the gem.
And they do lose the gem. Four heroes down, and they'll probably lose Roshan. It's exactly where Mind Control is headed right now. Meanwhile, Chalice and Somnus. Miracle's coming up behind them with the double damage rune, but a quick blink away from Chalice and then walk straight back over to him. That's the play. As Miracle, he'll spear straight past Somnus, but Mind Control, he's joined the fight. The Hex is out, combining with a Ravage! Goodbye, Miracle! Goodbye, Mind Control! The Aegis Immortal will pop. The rest of Liquid was thinking of coming over, but they're going to leave him for dead. A perfect timing stun from FY, and that is a dead Mind Control. This continues to burn the BKB charges. There's Gyrocopter coming in very, very close. Ember Spirit's going to get the Searing Chains off. Dro Ranger, Somnus just BKB's up. Mind Control, hello! He just jumped in. He sprouted, but he's actually locked inside the Roshan pit with Somnus. The Finger of Death will give the extra damage. Mind Control's down.
What?
And Roshan is up. Good question. Good question. What the hell indeed?
This guy has no chill, man. It's true.
Now they find Miracle with a Ravage. No. Chalice hits so hard. Miracle's down with no buyback available. Armies in the back lines. They're catching out all these cores. Weeha, he has to BKB and tries to push him back over. Somnus will walk back in again. You've got three LGD players licking their wounds in the back lines, but it won't matter when you've got the tanky immortal Arme on the front lines, killing off Weeha. Consume the cheese all you want. Take away the rest of your life into the follow-up stun. One after one after one. Team Liquid, they fall down. The struts are out of this house. A triple kill, an ultra kill for Somnus. They'll go back, they'll finish Roshan, they'll take the refresher shard, they'll take the top towers, the bottom, all the top towers. And they'll probably even take the game.
All the bottom towers.
All the towers.
All the refresher orbs. Really good.
This is going to be the last fight.
Communication as well.
This is totally going to be the last fight. LGD don't even start Roshan. Like, they've chipped him down a little bit, but they know Liquid will come to try and contest it. They know they'll smoke up. MKB done. Even got an Aeon Disc over on the SD, so getting these early pickoffs is even harder. ET with a Spirit, able to get the stomp off. Jarek up to court. Four heroes retreat. Bring him back. Miracle. Instantly Hex back up, and Finger of Death. He will just explode. They four-star him out. Kuro is giving some life and Somnus on 160 HP. He's still got the Satanic available. Now he'll trigger it. The SD will disrupt him up. It's actually wasting time with the Gust back. They're going to kill off Somnus as well as the Lion and SD. Team Liquid, they're going to try and take Roshan. Buyback comes in from Gyrocopter. Ravage still available from Chalice. He'll jump in! He'll hit the whole kit and caboodle! But is there some life? Weeha with the Gust back. He needs to push back still, but Kuro and Miracle retreating out through the north. They gave him the life, but look at Naga. She's charging forward. She wants to bring down Weeha. Mind Control is just trying to walk this off. Mate, the Song of the Siren! It's actually saving his life. Weeha almost killed him. Have they got anything to really get him? At the end of this song, the heart's kicked in. They get the life. The Finger of Death from FY puts down the Dro Ranger. Mind Control can TP back home to safety. Ember Spirit can buy back too. But can they defend? LGD can go either back for Roshan. You've got the cooldown talent now for Mind Control. He's going to be everywhere. But he needs to be home. It's in trouble.
I actually can't believe how good that fight was from Liquid, how much they accomplished. He jumped in with Miracle.
Yeah, he's getting up. Instead, is there a four-star? Yeah, there is. They'll get him back inside the base. As Gyrocopter trying to have his own little battle. The tier 4 towns have finally dropped down. That's a huge creep wave. They need to try and fight this one back. Gyrocopter will just BKB, finish off the Radiant Ancient. That's what they need to do. GH can't do anything. Finger down, Mind Control, trying to kill off Somnus, but the Titanic gave him all the life to survive this. And there's little to nothing that Miracle can do. Even the Rocket's able to hit. That is GG. LGD in 46 minutes, playing game one of this two-game series. Liquid versus LGD is what we're up for game two. Like, I was wondering, like, maybe he would just put the ward down after the fight had happened, so you get, like, better regeneration.
Oh, X-Nova
blast into an arrow, but the Burrow Strike gonna create a little bit of space. X-Nova with a Stick Charger, still not enough to survive. GH will find the kill, and Chalice, because he Burrow Strike in, has to Sandstorm defensively underneath his own tower.
And got something more done, but now it's too late, so.
X-Nova, even though he's level two, he wants to try and help out here. Dual Breathing over on top of Kuro. Hit the Liquid Fire with the Burrow Strike. Kuro, more than enough dots on him. Even the Stick Charges won't save him, and he knows it.
Oh, terrible. And I don't know how much he could have done about it, really. Oh, this smoke has to work.
Kuro's coming over.
Farmed. Oh, it's a double stack of golems.
He really wants to finish farming this one. FY is going to create a copy. TP support needs to come over, but here comes the ship. Here comes your Torrent as well. Miracle will go up and straight back down again. There's not enough regeneration inside that Alchemist to keep him alive. But Weeha has TP'd in, looking for a revenge onto X-Nova, and he will be able to claim it. Who else gets out? Everyone. The delivery system.
Special
package. They would like to get probably GH as the easier kill. Epicenter preparing up. They'll have to instantly blink and Burrow Strike into the trees. Almost none of it is hit on Weeha. Two pulses of the Epicenter only. He'll chain up an Ogre moving in under the cover of the Moonlight Shadow. Double sentries being played just in case one wasn't enough. But Chikiro just chains up with the multicast. Good defensive hit. And then the triple Burrow Strike. Team Liquid and the Torrent. Their feet are so wet. They're 6 feet under. Weeha, he'll go down as well. Miracle, run away.
Bonk. They even had time to TP in.
They're coming to fight again. This tower drops a miracle. If he gets the last hit, which he will, he can now go by the AC. But Chalice, this time he's going to hit with the Epicenter and the double Burrow Strike. They want to kill a Miracle and get the Chemical Rage up, but they have the damage output to get the kill. Weeha chains away. SK saved by FY. And maybe with the Purge, Weeha, who cannot walk away, he wants to chain again. The Burrow Strike barely misses from Chalice. He almost killed himself with it, but it won't matter. They're drawing him back with the X mark.
They got the tower. And sure, they lose two heroes here, but I still think this Roshan probably belongs to them.
Yeah, Somnus is looking. Torrent's gonna connect, sees the fact that Miracle has the double damage and he's already started it up. Weeha will be the neighborhood. So begin the poison spray, begin the Torrent spam. Moonlight Shadow from Team Liquid. Sentry wards, where are they right now? As the arrow, the chain stuns, they're gonna be absolutely perfect on top of the Chikira, but the GA protecting Liquid. They still haven't taken out Roshan yet. Somnus is in the middle of the pit. Weeha chaining himself back out, but he's pulled back in again. Nowhere he wants to be, especially with the Spirit Vessel on top of him. Again, he is down with the Alchemist and the Torrent. It's going to make it impossible to actually get the hit into Roshan. Who's going to kill him? Killed by the Radiant. That the Aegis, the model, snatched out by Somnus. He'll be able to survive. His army just goes ham. Look at him just rip everybody apart. Get over here!
Okay,
GH will go down to everyone from Liquid is dead.
If he's Heavenly Grace, there's kind of no way he gets chain stunned until death, so he will get the BKB off, but...
Really nice Observer Ward. That scattered out the smoke. Mind Control wasn't up the hillside before that happened. Somnus has already got the kill onto the tower. Cleans up the creep wave. So Alchemist would love to run around the back. He wants the fight. The BKB's there. They want to get in on this engagement. But you've also got the delivery service. Chalice is ready once again. Just walk up a hill. Here comes your movement forward. Miracle already looking for the hit, and they've got the kill over on the Chikira. So no Ice Path shenanigans in this case. And they do have the extra follower. Weeha moving in. The Epicenter is doing heavy amounts of damage. They all push back up again. Mind Control so low, but he gets the GA off, allowing Weeha to stand and fight Miracle. This time around, he's got all the life, and Weeha and Mind Control causing all sorts of problems in the back lines, allowing Miracle to finally bring down Chalice. They'll have the buybacks in, and they're looking to push forward. A quick blink away. Miracle is out to safety. Weeha, maybe not so lucky, but remember, he's the tanky one. Hold him in the ice pump. Doesn't have a lot of charges to go on that reactive armor, so they can bring him down.
Thanks.
SD becomes the greatest hero ever. Moonlight Shadow, Team Liquid looking to find. Ame is the man presenting himself close, but remember, we are during nighttime phase, so the vision game is not fantastic. In fact, it's LGD who have the Observer and Sentry down, so they see the Sentry being planted, so that allowed BKB from Somnus to be triggered. He just got the slight early warning system, and SK Chalice ready to go again with the blink. Burrow Strike over on two, into the Epicenter. What's he got? Kuro, that's what they've got. Didn't even need to use the Epicenter. Pyro Strike's off cooldown in 3 seconds' time. Blink's gonna take a little longer than that, but with the Purge Mind Control having a hard time getting away as Weeha brought back with the X Mark spot into the macro Pyro and Ice Bath. No way to escape, or does he? Timber Chain up, but he's still being locked in position. Another X Mark spot. It just keeps coming. Lotus Orb, it won't care. A double kill for Ame.
Okay.
But Chemical Rage is on cooldown for 17 more seconds. So this is
a really big moment.
This is the only downside. Like, they don't have that available. There's no BKB on the Kunkka. There's no protection from Somnus. The smoke in the back lines, delivery system SK is ready to go, and he'll instantly go on top of Weeha with a burst out. Weeha! Instantly explodes! They'll get they can't even get the rebuttal because FY, defensive disruption. Somnus, they can't protect him enough. Miracle sitting right on top of him, moving his attention over towards Ame. The back under the tower, another Ice Path will connect, and another double Burrow Strike from Chalice. Kuro's low in life, the GA will pop up as Miracle. He looks over towards Jakiro and able to bring him down inside the tree line. Push to the tier 2 tower in mid, and he blinks again. Another disruption from FY, trying to control up Miracle, using this Radiant Sperm for his advantage. He's just taking them AWOL away from the rest of the heroes, and that allows him to go on top of Mind Control. Ame moves forward, Miracle does have the triple kill, but Ame is the bigger beast, bringing down Kuro. And he knows he matches up well against the Alchemist.
He didn't leap, he had three leaps.
They want to get the ward.
The ward is still there.
They're going to get the D ward now. Observer and Sentry is down. TP's coming on top of the ward. The blink bar is strike forward. Kuro, he could die so quickly. Ame, he's able to hold him in position. Miracle, Concoction will fly over to Chalice. He was able to get himself pushed down into the lane. Ice Bar trying to create more space. But the issue is really for FY. He gets the disruption over on Miracle, but Weehan's already taken the SD's life. Chalice wants to take at least somebody back, or at least he'll take him in with a bar strike forward. Now Ame has to go to work. Optimum protected by that Aeon Disc. They still want to kill him off with the boat. He connects and the Torrent. They just hold them in position. The GA cannot do enough work.
And maybe Miracle, so weak right now.
He doesn't have that Chemical Rage anymore. Pulled back into the Ice Path. Oh, GH! He went back into it too! Weeha! He's now the next target. Timber chains himself back up, but once again, the Torrent grabs him, pulls him back. And everyone's just checking Roshan. I love how Chalice is doing it. He's the all the Torrent. Connects over on Weeha. Chalice, he comes up Fire Strike. They're looking to take out Kuro at the very start. A quick force up. Gets Kuro further away, but no, the Tidebringer.
It
hits so hard, and with the boat coming in, it's really problematic. But they're underneath the shrine. Team Liquid, the regeneration combining with the GA is still not enough. A double buyback is required, and one from SK2. Somnus just wants to walk this one off, but Miracle wants to kill him. And they've got him too. Mind Control actually gets the double kill, but Ame trying to go to work over on Weeha. Too much armor to work with, but the epicenter from Chalice and the triple Barrow Strike, putting Liquid in a rough position. The Barrow Strike, okay, he stuns on FY. He's the man on the front lines, creating copies of Miracle, and actually those SD illusions helping Ame to finish the job, but that's where you get the buyback in from the Alchemist. TP out towards the shrine. Weeha getting hit by yet another Spirit Vessel. They've protected. The Lotus Orb is up, and now GH flies the arrow forward. No one's gonna get hit by that one. Splits both the Creep Wave as well as the three heroes.
Oh,
at Miracle, he's too far forward. The Overwind's trying to break him free. The Torrent, as the ship, they push him all back to Miracle. Force up, but Chalice will stay with him, and they bring him down. 2 minutes on the sideline after the dive back, and Ame once more. Mind Control will TP out. Weeha, he has to intercept the creep waves or something, but no, he gets X marks. He's going to be pulled back in once again. Chalice has the Burrow Strike, but the Timber Chain. Weeha with the TP away. No! The Burrow Strike! It pulls him back in. The Lotus Orb also works against him too, with the Torrent combination, cancelling the chain away. Weeha, he shall fall. There's enough poison on him without buyback. Timber is down, and this should be the game once again. LGD walk down the mid to claim the GG. Depends how hard and fast they push, but it's a minute and a half window. Tier 4s, that'll be the next target. Yeah, they're going to end this now.
Look at Lifestealer just mauling this. 5 seconds per tower. He's not even raging for it.
He doesn't need to. There's no real threat. The Burrow Strike comes in on Mind Control. He's protected a little bit, but now Ame in for the open wounds. Mind Control will lose it, but then he gets caught in the Torrent ship combination. They force staff him up almost inside the Ice Path. But the tier 4 towers are totally lost. They're doing everything they can, Liquid, to try and repel LGD. But Miracle will concede it with the GG call. LGD will 2-0 the series, keeping that top position in the group stage.